Hello everyone, it's Lindsay, and today I'm diving into the Living Water Devotional Kit from By the Well for God. I do have an unboxing on my channel that you can check out and see what all comes in the kit, but I am so excited to dive in and play with this kit. It is super cute, and I am just excited to dive into this devotional content. So I am working in Matthew chapter 16, and this is going to be verses 15 all the way through 17, which I'll read in just a few minutes here. But to begin with, I'm going to do some emboss resist technique. So I'm taking this stamp set here. This is one of the extra ones that you can pick up with the kit. They will be restocked next week, so don't worry. I know they're not available currently if you didn't get your hands on it. It is coming back into stock next week, so definitely be sure to head on over to By the Well for God and check that out. And there's this big wave piece, and it can be stamped right next to each other, and so you have one continuous wave piece. So I am going to stamp and emboss this with clear embossing powder. So I want to make sure that I really prep the page very well with my EK6S powder tool. And this is laying down powder onto the page that's going to take away any stickiness, any moisture, any fingerprints, any static cling, anything like that that might be on the page. And that way my embossing powder only sticks to my stamping. I'm going to ink this up with Versamark, which is a clear sticky ink. If you have questions about embossing or want more information, I did just do a Tip Tuesday this week all about embossing, so I will link that down below and you can check that out for more details. But I'm going to go ahead and stamp that down. Now, it is clear, so you're not going to be able to see the stamping. It does leave a little bit of a watermark type look, so I can see it in person, but on camera it's going to be kind of hard to see. I'm going to apply some Wow Clear Embossing Powder and apply it really generously. I want to make sure that it's completely covering everything that I stamped. I can tap off the excess there, and I was just making sure that it got a good impression. I'm going to go ahead and pour the extra back into the container. This is normally all white. Mine has little flecks of like eraser shavings and all kinds of dirtiness. I need to get a new one because it is kind of dirty. And then I can go ahead and heat set this with my heat tool. And again, it's going to be kind of hard to see, but you can see once it has melted and gotten shiny, it kind of has this watermark look to it. So you could even do just this, leave it as it is, and have this really faint impression on your page. But I'm going to go ahead and do some more things to it. So I am repeating this process, prepping the page, inking up the stamp, and I'm going to stamp it. Now, I kind of cut my head out of here because I got right up over the top of my page to make sure I was lining these up right next to each other. So it looks like one continuous wave pattern. I did go ahead and apply embossing powder, heat set that, same as I did the first impression. Now, because I did this in clear embossing powder, I can still see all of the text underneath it. But now we're going to bring out those waves. So I just have a clean paintbrush, and this is clean, clear water that I'm applying to the page within that stamped image. And this is just going to help the colors kind of blend together because I am going to use a combination of blues and greens, and I want everything to really blend well. So I'm applying just some plain water first, and then I can go ahead and pick up different colors from this watercolor palette. And these are a bunch of different Prima watercolors that I've combined into this tin. And I'm just going to begin dropping color into the image. And I am staying within the stamped lines. It is hard to see on camera, but in person I can pretty well see where the embossed images are. And so what this is going to do is as I add color, you're going to be able to see that the embossing powder actually resists the watercolor. So you'll be able to see this image of the stamped, you know, the stamped embossed image and still be able to see all the text. This does work better with darker colors, so I am going to come back in and kind of intensify this color. That way you can really see that embossing. And so as I work, again, like I said, I'm working in Matthew chapter 16, and verses 15 through 17 say, "He said to them," and this is Jesus saying, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter replied, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered him, "Blessed are you, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven." So throughout this devotional, we are going to be talking about the living water and Jesus and what that means and what that is, and the areas in the Bible where we can see that. Real quick on screen here, I let this air dry. Do not heat set it or it will reactivate your embossing powder. So I set it aside for a couple hours, let it air dry. And now I'm taking a clean, dry paper towel to buff off any of the watercolor that might be sitting on top of that embossed ink. So this is a very faint contrast between the two, but you can see that stamped image popping through the watercolors. So back to the scripture. So at this time, a lot of the people were thinking that Jesus was just a really good prophet, you know, a really great rabbi. But as time was going on, and the more he was preaching and speaking, people were beginning to realize that, no, he is, in fact, the Messiah that was prophesied back in the Old Testament. And so this is where that is kind of being revealed. So I'm excited to dive into the rest of this devotional content and kind of see where it takes us with this. So I hope you guys have picked it up for yourself. If not, definitely head on over and grab it. It is still available. I think this is going to be a really good one to work through. Lori always has wonderful devotional content with her kits. So you can see I went ahead and added some of the die cut pieces down at the bottom, and now I'm going through and adding some alpha stickers. These are the alpha stickers, the clear ones and the tile ones that you can pick up in addition to the kit as an add-on. So definitely check that out. It gives you plenty of color options. Now my die cuts do cover up some of the text at the bottom there, and this is my fifth journaling Bible. And so I do all of my studying and reading in a separate Bible, and then this Bible is just for my art journaling. So if text gets covered up, it doesn't bother me, but you could leave that off or maybe stamp the images or something like that, and kind of suit it to what your needs are. But I don't mind covering the text, just because this, I'm not reading out of this particular Bible. So I went ahead and created that little title over there, Jesus is the Son of the Living God, and that comes from the scripture. And then now I'm going to create a little tab clustering. I do like to cut the washi strips in half just so I get more use out of them. And then there are plenty of tab options in the die cuts. I'm just trying to find one that works with the colors that I have on the page here. And I'll adhere that down with the washi tape. I am going to add one of the fabric clippies, but I am going to retie that into a separate kind of bow. You can see in my unboxing video how I do that. And then off camera, I went ahead and just added a really quick, short little prayer journaling underneath there. And I'm also going to highlight the verses using a Faber-Castell big brush marker. These markers do not bleed through your Bible pages. They are permanent once they are dry. Lori has a great sale always on those markers, so you can go find those over there. I'm going to add just some little watercolor splatters just to add some more detail to the waves and kind of tie everything together down there, kind of connect it with the lettering and things like that that I did. And now I'm going to add these as a finishing touch. These are some Nuvo crystal drops. I will link the particular color down below. I can't remember which ones these are, but these ones dry translucent with a slight blue color. So I'm creating some little like bubbles. And they're kind of like a faux enamel dot, so, or like a glossy accent, but these do have a blue tint to them. It's kind of hard to see on camera, but in person you can see it has this really fun kind of bubble effect. These do take about 24 hours to dry, so I just lay my Bible aside, open, let it dry overnight, and then these are all ready to go. I will link those down below as well. If you have any questions or comments, be sure to leave those down in the comments, and I'll just jump on in there and have a conversation with you guys. Check out the links in the description box as well as over on my blog for all the products mentioned today. Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and subscribe to my channel if you're not already subscribed. And until next time, thank you so much. Bye-bye.